all of you, because in this difficult period we are here all together to try to anyway to improve, to try to do our best, especially in this period that we don't have so many competitions. Actually, we don't have competitions, so we can have the possibility to change more our dancing, our knowledge, to improve as much as possible. First of all, I want to thank so much the WDC that is giving to all the WDC members this possibility. And to us as a teacher, it's a great honor that we can join, we can do this web seminar, and also share with all of you our experience, our knowledge, our information. So, first of all, I want to say that WDC is a historical organization that we are all proud to be part of this, because in general, how you can see also in this period, the organization are not taking care so much about the dancers, and they're only thinking to organize to, I don't know, to give to the people the possibility to organize their own competition or to do something else. But in these cases, really, you can see that the WDC is giving the opportunity to the WDC members to have these study sections that we can learn from home, from your studio, from your house, from your city, without traveling. And this is, I think, a big, big help. And so, once again, thank you so much to the WDC that this, with the president, Donny Barnes, that they are trying to involve the dancers all from all over the world to try to improve, to continue the studying. And so when there will be again the competition, for sure, everybody, we will be more ready, and everything will be much, much better. So, my title tema of today is what we lost and what we gained. So, what we lost and what we gained. Unfortunately, I have more idea for what we lost, because we are in 2020. Actually, this year, 2020, is better that it's finished as early as possible, because it doesn't look so fabulous. But in this 2020, so past many years, that the ballroom dance is born from many, many years ago. And we could see in the all these years how many changing in the dancing happened. And until the 2020 that we are now, how the dancing, the ballroom dancing change, and also the musicality change, the step change, the posture change, the way how to think, how to study change. We cannot say that change in better way or in a worse way, but for sure in the years change a lot. And what I really, no, I don't like, but what I would like that we can share these informations together. Today, I want to let you understand to all the dancers that are looking at me today, that this is my view, my point of view, of course, and I want to share with you that first of all, it's very important that the couples, the dancers, are trusting their teacher. Because the teacher is the most important point for dancers, that you can find in your teacher, your friend, your partner, your inspiration, you want to imitate the teacher. So the teacher is on top of the list that is should give you all his best or all her best to each of you, but you need to give the full trust. What I mean the full trust? In the last years, for the last generation, is the wrong habit is to take too many lessons with all great teachers. I don't mean that your lessons that you are doing with all these teachers are wrong, but because you get many information, because we all the teachers want to arrive in one direction, but all of us, we are using different words, we use different head, we use a different way how to arrive in the end that all the teacher want to join the same point. But because the information, sometimes I explain in different ways, with different words, in different language, the couples easily, they can lose the track. And lose the track, it means that you lose your personality, you lose your identity, just because, not because the information that you got are wrong, just because the information sometimes they look opposite to each other, even that they are not, but because every teacher, they are using their own way to catch, to reach the point. And automatically taking so many lessons, it's easy that you lose your track. And when we lose the track, we don't know what we have to do during the practice. Because the practice, the good practice are the secret of the improvement of the dancing. But to have a good practice, we must also have clear information in our head that this information we work today, tomorrow, the day after, for a week, 1 month, 6 months, until this information is coming natural in our body. But sometimes we have 3, 4, 5, 10 informations, all of 10 correct, but you don't know which one you want to follow. So you have to find a teacher that is for you, in your head, in your heart, in your feeling, is for you. I mean that you really give your trust and you have to listen to this teacher, and then maybe this teacher will give you the info to go to another teacher to increase, to improve other subject. But you must always have, when I was a dancer, I was also going to take a lesson with the many coaches, but not too many. And I was booking the coaches, the teachers that I felt that they could speak my language in the dancing world. And then anyway, even that they were all fantastic teachers, when I was coming back to Italy, I have my Italian coach that I was explaining what this wonderful teacher was explaining to me. And then together with our Italian coach, we were finding the way how what we want to do and what we want to put a little bit to the side, and then maybe take 1 month later, 2 months later, or the week after. We didn't know in that moment, but depends also how is the improvement. So that's why my suggestion of today, I'm starting with this subject, because from here it can be everything much more clear and easy for each of you. So trust one teacher, listen to this teacher, even that maybe the information that you got in that moment is not what you want to listen in that moment, but the teacher is having the experience to see from outside and not from inside for what you feel, because many times what we feel is not what we show, what the people can see from outside. So the teacher can only help you looking from outside and from his experience what is the most important things for you today, and maybe what we can do tomorrow or in 1 month or in 1 year. So, but changing many times the information is only creating a stress and confusion in your head. So what I said before, easily we can lose the identity. Easily we can lose our personality. Easily we can lose our charismatic interpretation. And when you are on the floor, actually, all of you that you dance a competition, in general, you are competing against the people of your level. So no one of you is so terrible. So it's easy that many couples are looking in the same way. But to find your personality, to find your identity, you have to understand inside of yourself which style of dancing you want to dance. And this is, for me, what we lost in this period. Because not in the period of the lockdown, not in the period of this tragic COVID-19. I mean, in the last years. For me, the ballroom dancing is a great art that I really believe, because this is my life. I think this is also your life from many years. But using in the wrong way this art is only becoming something with that the art is lost. Only athletic, or only gymnastic, or only sometimes not real. I don't want to say fake, but sometimes it doesn't look real. Just it looks like a copy of somebody. And when we copy somebody, we are not anymore ourselves. And some of you can ask me maybe now, how I can find which is my style? How I can know which is the right information for myself? Okay, to give the answer to the second question is your teacher will help you for sure to recognize which information is good for you in that moment. About your identity, in which style and how you want to present your dance is only you, because you have the possibility to look in the past or to look in the present right now, which couple you like the most. Which style you like the most. Doesn't mean that the other style that you don't like are wrong, but which style you see yourself more. And maybe you choose one of these style, and this style maybe for you is what you like, what you feel, and you start to study in this style. But sometimes maybe this style is good to the couple that you were looking for, but maybe doesn't look good on you. And that, again, is your teacher that will help you to see, okay, maybe this step is, or maybe this interpretation is not fantastic on you. That it looks good to this couple, but doesn't look good to you. And you don't have to take it like a person, like that you are losing in that moment. No, you are learning how to find your way, how to express yourself in the best way, because in competition, easily, especially in the first rounds, there are the couples that they are looking almost all the same, because in the level when we go in competition, we expect that all of you are on time, all of you are taking clean and clear position, and all of you are learning, you learn some steps that you produce a routine during your competition. But if the steps are and also the way how you take position, the way how you interpret it, it looks okay, doesn't make any difference between you and the other 15 couples on the floor. If you want to become more visual, if you want to become more special, don't try to do something that is not good, but try to find inside of yourself which interpretation, which time you want to use in this figure, which step you want to put in your routine that will allow you these steps to present yourself in the best way. So only in this way you will have the possibility to express yourself. Now, another point to connect to this one is, doesn't mean that I want to find my way. Now I start to be like actual like in the circus. No. The fundamental of the ballroom dancing are very important. And here I am connected to another point. And then I will show you what I'm saying now. I am connected to another point that this means that I want to be special, I want to be original, I want to have my personality and I must have my identity. Fantastic. But we don't have to lose the technique. And we don't have to escape from the details. Because I think in this period, the details and the technique easily, we are like putting in the time. Something that is okay. We are putting in our side. So because more information now is go, run, arms up, smile, and open the legs, try to move as much as possible. Of course, the movement in the ballroom dancing is important, because in the ballroom dancing, we need a big floor to express in the best way our, to produce in the best way our movement. Latin couple, they can dance their own routine in the small space, and anyway, it looks fantastic. In the ballroom dancing, the movement, for me, the three important ingredients are timing, position, and movement. But how we move is important, not just open the legs, run, energy, and go. Because if we do like that, we become only athletic, which is important, the athletic part. But it's important that the way how we express the beauty of the feet, the beauty of the harmony of the arms, and the, because we dance with the hands, we dance with the arms, we dance with the body, we dance with the legs, we dance with the feet. So all are details that we must control and study to express and to find with our idea, together with our teacher, how we want to express in that moment of this figure or in which kind of music, but also it's important that in the moment that we are producing the movement, we are also showing how beautiful way we can use the feet, the harmony in our body. Now, I hope until now is clear. We are not dancing alone. We dance with our partner. And this is the strong, difficult part. To have a partner that is having the same goal as you. To have a partner that physically you can join the dancing together. To have a partner that he wants or she wants to sacrifice himself or herself in the same way as you. So to be connected mentally with another person that maybe until today was a stranger. So I mean, was not a part of your life. And suddenly this partner become more than your husband or more than your wife, or sometimes also become in the end your wife and your husband. So to be together with another person and to share the knowledge and study the practice, to share the life with this person is not the easy point, because easily I can understand something, but in the same moment, in this exactly the same moment that we are listening together the information, to me is arriving something, to my partner in the same moment, the same person that is explained is arriving another thing. And easily we can fight after when we are going to practice, because both of us, we think that we were in the correct way. But this is not a problem, because actually same information started from one teacher arrived to two persons in two different ways, because we have our brain and our feeling that we have our personality. Each of us, we are two personalities that we have to join together without killing each other. Two personalities has to join together. And this, in this moment, you can present talking, arguing also, because the argue is not a bad moment. The argue is helping you to understand your partner and to your partner to understand you. So in that moment, you are not losing the time. In that moment, you are using the time to understand each other and to create a team together to produce something together to show to the people, to the teachers, to the judges during the competition. But first of all, you understand for yourself. So that's why it's really, really important that we don't have to kill each other, our personality, but we have to share two personalities to become in one. But sometimes there are couples that the man is more adrenalinic and the lady is, she's more calm, or opposite, the lady, she's so much over the top sometimes, and the man is more quiet. It's not wrong. This is the, maybe can be the best partnership, because maybe when the man, in this case, maybe the man is too much, the lady can keep in him the calmness and help him to be more clear. And when it's opposite, the same. Or opposite, if I am too much under stress, a calm person close to me can let me have the balance. So ballroom dancing, like Latin dancing, but ballroom dancing, we have also the connection of the bodies, It's not easy on this subject, but this is the beauty of the ballroom dancing, where when two persons can really share and join the knowledge, the information, their own personality together to become two persons in one. That's why, for me, what we lost in this period, in these years, and for me, the ballroom dancing had a little bit, a moment that is a little bit in the flat line, and for me this is terrible, because I am really believing that the ballroom dancing is a very great, great art, and to be sure, and I want to be sure, that the ballroom dancing will go more up as possible, and with the improvement, with the beauty, is to don't lose the harmony between the couple. The man is the leader, and the woman is following. To be a good leader doesn't mean man, that you have to take your partner, take with a lot of energy and move. No, you have to be clear. The best leading that we can receive from the man is the clear information. Clear doesn't mean perfect. Even in the mistake, you have to be clear. Until today, you have this information. What this information is giving to you, you have to be understandable for your partner, that in that moment after, she must be ready to follow your informations and to develop your information in her own way. Because sometimes, ladies, you are worried to disturb the men. A you men, sometimes, I am very nice and polite, sometimes, you are worried that the lady don't understand you, and you are just using your energy. And of course, the men, you men, you have more energy than us. And the reaction on the women is the worst, because we feel like in a shaker. We don't touch even with, sometimes with the feet to the floor. We are only like a doll in your arm, that we have to just focus in you. No. We have to focus to understand, and that's why you must be understandable. We have to focus to understand what you want to do, if you want to change the step, which interpretation you want to give in the step, how long you want to stay in the step. So this is our focus. But then we have our brain, we have our body, we have our own personality. Then we want to express, we want to have the freedom to express our interpretation during your information. So for me, this is a strong point. This is what, for me also, this point, we lost, because it looks at who arrived first in the end of the floor is the winner. No. Who arrived better in the end of the floor is the winner. And the better way, I can say that is in which harmony, in which warm atmosphere we create. If we become interesting to the people, to the judges, that they look at us, we become something not unusual, because we are like in the circus, but because we give something in that moment. Because if we are only listening the informations of the teacher, one teacher, the main one, that is helping you to understand the other teachers. So I go back to the point of before. If we are, if we focus only what the teacher is saying to us, yes, it's important. But then maybe the teacher say, move, go in that one. I want that you have more power. Yes, but in which way I want to have the power? The power, what it means? These are the questions that you must give to your teachers. So, move, how? Power, want to see power. In which way? Let me see more volume. How can create the volume? Going back with my neck, going back with my back, or pushing forward my center. So you must pretend that the clear informations from your teachers, that you must understand in the best way what you have to do the day after when you go to practice. Because if you just listening, and sometimes we finish, you finish the lesson, and you just say yes, 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 because you're worried to disturb, you are not disturbing the teacher. If you ask, can you please tell me again? Can you explain in another way? Because in this way, I don't understand. For me, it's not enough clear. Can you tell me how? So the teacher must, and is, will be very happy to give you another explanation. If it's not enough, he will give you another one. We have enough experience to find a way to be understandable to each of you, because we are not everybody the same. When I was studying, when I was young, when I was going to the school, I was having my method of study. The person that was sitting close to me was also good, was having his own method. All, everybody has their own method of how to study. The most important that when the teacher was asking to us what we learn, we were ready to give the right answer, but with different method of studying. And that is what I'm still want. I still want to let you understand that you must listening, and when you don't understand, you must ask to your main teacher that will give you the possibility to, in one way, not, in another way, not clear, he will find a way. But if you say yes, the teacher can understand that you understood. And then you go to practice, and the information for you was not, maybe for sure the teacher gave you the right information, but didn't arrive clear on you, you go to practice, and then you are practicing the wrong way. And this is another point. The practice is important, but if we practice in the right way. If I go to practice just because I want to dance 2-3 hours and do stamina, stamina is important. But again, I'm touching the point. It's not important how far I'm going, and if I arrive the first in the end of the floor, and if I take 2 minutes in athletic way without any problem, which dance. Yes, it's also important, but it's not the only one. It's important the way how we dance, the way how we express ourselves. Some years ago, there was, unfortunately, one division in the dancing world. This division didn't help the dancers, didn't help the dancing world, didn't help the dancers, didn't help the teachers. Only create confusion. And the biggest things that this division created that killed the history. The young generation now, you, the young generation, you are having YouTube to watch, to give, to have, for sure, from YouTube, many inspiration. But learning and copying from YouTube is a big mistake. Because if I'm learning without knowing what I'm seeing is the final result, and I need to know what this couple did to arrive there. For sure, we can learn also with our eyes, watching and seeing what the couples are doing. But it's not only that. In my period, we didn't have the YouTube. We had the tapes that sometimes we were lucky to find and put in the television. We could see how much we could see sometimes. We didn't have the possibility to record ourselves during our practice. So we had to trust in our period, and this is what I want to tell you, that we had to trust, and I want that you are trusting, your feeling, your heart, yourself, listening to the information of the teachers. Not just recording yourself, watching yourself, then you don't like this, you do this. This can be something that we can add. But if we are only video ourselves, and then we watch YouTube, and then we copy one figure, and then we go in the studio, we practice this figure without saying anything to our teacher, and then maybe after we go to take a lesson with some teachers, other teachers, and we show this figure that we learn by ourselves watching YouTube, we create only confusion. We create a confusion, and we create a not realistic dancing, not real dancing that we can trust first ourselves, and then we can let the people that they trust ourselves to. Because if I don't convince myself, if I'm not clear about inside of myself, I cannot convince the other. So if you want to improve your dancing, you have to understand what you're doing, what you have to do to be better. And then in that way, after, when you know the exact details and technique, you have to put your personality, your identity, your charisma. This is very important. I cannot create a charisma, identity, personality without knowing exactly how I have to put this foot, how I have to do this figure, which interpretation I can have, some options, and then you can discover in these some options your option, or maybe you can discover one that you feel even better than the option that you had. But you can have this ability when you know exactly how you can stand on your feet, how you can use your feet in the best way, how you use your knees, your ankles, all your joints, your body. Because we dance with everything, with the head, with the neck, with the shoulder, with the body, with the center, with the hips, with the legs, with the knees, with the ankles, and with the feet. And our best friend is the floor. If I'm using all myself, if you listen carefully, I say all myself. Couples between two people, but two people are two individual people. So each of these individual people has to use himself or herself in the best way. And our best friend in the dancing world is the floor, where we use our body weight into the floor. And from the floor, we can take the energy, the balance, we can use our body weight to be able to transfer, like when you walk, the body weight from one foot to the other foot. Don't let me see like that example that you want to do a step, just you see only my top, just a second, okay? If you want to do a step, just because you want to open the step, because the teacher said to you, open your leg, create a big movement, create a big step, because I wanted to arrive in the end of the floor as fast as possible in the much power that you can create. No, it's important that you know how you can use the pressure of the feet on the floor. So the pressure on the feet on the floor. So I need to have the full using of my feet on the floor, that is my friend that is giving me the possibility to balance myself. And if you see me, I have all the time my legs under my body. Or if I go forward or backward, sideways here. If I want to turn, my feet all the time must be under my body, like when we walk. And when we walk, I don't see nobody that is walking like that. I don't see nobody that is opening the legs to walk. We are walking using the foot pressure of the hand leg, and the body weight will help us to create the step. Or when I go back, I don't see anybody that's walking like that. This is the nightmare of the ladies. I want to create space for my partner, so I need to create space. Yes, you're opening the legs, but your body stays on your partner. So actually your partner doesn't have space because the legs are open, but your body is on him. Another teacher tells you this, and then what you say, okay, I understand. Allora, I create more space from my part of the body. I want to create the body. But you are not in balance. To be in balance, you need to stay vertical on your feet. When I am in balance, I am the queen of my body. And the man can be the king of his body. But without the balance, nothing is possible. Especially because we are two persons that we are dancing together. And we need to cooperate with each other. But I can't cooperate if
I can give my best part to my partner, and the partner can give me his best part to me. What we lost? We lost also a lot, because there are some action that, okay, some style that the people like more to be vertical. Like if I go on promenade, okay, I can be more vertical, or I can use more sway to go on promenade, or if I am a man, I can use more sway to go on promenade. If I change, I change. So I can use more sway, and the sway starting when I'm changing under. Not now what I'm seeing. This is what I say, that is not here. That I'm changing from the upper. I don't move anything here, and we move from the arms. This is for me, circles. Or I see the ladies that they are breathing the neck, or that I can even copy because I will feel pain on myself. They want to create a big line instead of to change the hips, like in finance, always say, instead of to change the hips and the upper part is following what I am creating under, they just change and drop the sides. And when we drop the body, the action is finished. So we become like robotic. And this is what I mean. I'm coming again close to you. This is what I mean that... Okay, this is what I mean, that this is not real dancing. So to be real, we need to be clear, full. Everything that we do has to be in harmony. Because if you men stress your partner, and this is what I don't want that we lose, you don't have to lose the harmony with your partner. If you stress your partner to do something that you think by yourself that is good, doesn't mean that is wrong. Maybe it's correct what you say. But give the time to your partner, or opposite, also the lady to the man. The partners must give time to each other to work with the information inside of the body, to take out the best what the body can give you. To be a couple means there is a leader, that the man is the leader, okay? But to be a good partner doesn't mean that we are a doll inside of the arm and then we just follow what he's doing, no? The man has to be clear. But you ladies, you must be even more clear, even more understandable for yourself that what you do, and not just because you learn 20 steps and you follow your partner, no. Each step that you do, you must have a clear stability, clear information on each step that you do. Not 20 steps, you are clear in the beginning, clear in the ending, and in the middle, question mark. No. 20 steps, 20 clear actions, step by step. Then, in that way, in that moment, you can use your personality, you can find your identity, you can present yourself also in a more charismatic way, but not just cancel the details and then going only to, today I feel like that, and tomorrow, and the day after. So, how you can prepare your career in the best way for competition, because all of you that you are listening to me now, all of you are dancers. So if all of you want to become a dancer, you are already a dancer. But we decide to be also competitor. Our world is a competitive world. And to be a good competitor, you must be better to other couples. Instead of the other couples. So to be a good dancer, you are a good dancer, but you decide to be also a competitor together with another person, because we are not dancing alone. And this is what I'm really put my finger in the same point, because we are not dancing alone. So both two persons are together, because if you find a person that is having or she's having the same goal, they want to have the same sacrifice. So if these two persons meet to each other, this is already a big team, then these two persons want to achieve the same goal. So respect your partner, give time to your partner. If today your partner still is not like you would like, or is not like you want to feel, maybe tomorrow, maybe she or he need 2 days longer, 1 week longer, 1 month longer, we don't know. But with the stress, this is not possible. If you stress yourself, if you stress the other person, nothing good will come out. It's only stressing. And you know what is the real ending? That one of the parts of the partnership is only like make the other one happy without be happy himself or herself. And this is very visual from outside. You can see when the dancers, men and women, are responsible of what they do. You can see easily when the couples are surviving on the floor. And you can see very easy also when there are the couples that they are clear, they know exactly what they want to do. Maybe not perfect, but in their mistake, they are clear. It's impossible to be perfect, but it's possible to be as clear as possible, to let the people understand which message you want to send to them. So we are like, the dancers are like a book. And for me, we lost a little bit this book. I mean, the book is, we are like a book because we are writing with our dancing some words, and the people that are watching at us, they are the readers, and they need to understand and be able to read what we are writing in our book. Our body, in the artistic way, is creating words, creating a book that the people need to see, okay, this I like because I am understanding what they do. I can read what they do. But if there is a confusion, if you don't create your style, because you want to achieve, and this is another point, you want to achieve a result as fast as possible. Also, the most talented people, they need time. Maybe they are a little bit faster than others, but we need time to put the information, to understand the information, to listen information, understand, and put these informations inside of our body and let them be as much as possible easy and fluid and natural. Because when we are artificial, like I can say before, I said before, when we are artificial with the head, or sometimes they go totally back, or contra-check instead of to dance, contra-check. The contra-check is a very stable step where the body weight is between two legs. Then I can stretch myself. I can be fast in tango, but I have a limit. If I go over the limit, we can do it in the show. But if we speak about competitive dancing during competition, I must have all the time, like, as a woman, all the time, my center that is under me, that is supporting me. And then I can stretch. Maybe young lady now can stretch a little bit more than me, but without losing their center. This is my center, okay? The body is on top of the center. If I want to go back with my upper part of the body, I need to change my hips. So if I put my hips back, example like that, my body is going forward. If I push my hips forward, my body is going back. So now question mark, how much I need to
push, if I want to create, example, my contract check. This is my center. Then contract check down. This is my base. I cannot do that. If I do that, I'm losing because I'm transferring my body weight only on one foot. And the contract check, the body weight has to be between two legs. Also, woman, men, between two legs. And then you can go a little bit with your interpretation forward, but not on the lady. Sometimes I'm seeing contour checks where the man is totally on the lady and the lady is totally back.
For me, this is not harmony. This is a circus interpretation because also there is a new version of this in Waltz or in Slow Fox. There is one word that the people I use, infinity. Infinity is infinity. I can have my infinity. All of you, you can have in each of you your own infinity. The infinity can be one right word, but I don't give the right sense to this word. Because for me, infinity is something that is not real. Infinity. Where? I can express myself, I can lead my partner if I am a man. You can lead the partner. You can follow your partner, women, only when you are in balance. When we are in balance, when we are cutting easily this part, I don't know if you see me. When I am bending my knees, and you see that my knees is going always forward. This part is cutting. This part cutting doesn't mean that I am like that. No. But if I go to the gym and the teacher is asking to me, can you please bend your legs, your knees? I do this. And this is normal. It's impossible to bend the knees doing that. Keeping the hips straight. For Simona, this joint is very important. Because this joint is giving me the freedom if I want to pass into the floor. I can use this joint. I can use this joint. This is natural. Actually, this is this I have. I cannot cut. I cannot put this in. Something is going out. The belly. And my back, you can see often the ladies that they have big volume and the shoulder are round, the neck are like that. The beauty of the ladies is also how beautiful we can have our neck to produce always a long line, never break. But if I want to pretend that I am using my body weight on the floor, so I'm using my knees, I'm using my feet, and I don't use this joint on my hips, everything's blocked. And I cannot pretend after to be in balance. So I hope this message that I'm giving to you is clear enough that I'm not saying to don't do your interpretation. No, because I started my lecture today that I want that you find your way how to express yourself. But to express yourself, you must do stay in balance on your feet. And not only the man, that often, more often, the man is having more balance than the lady. Okay, we have less energy than the man. Okay, we are often moving backward. Okay, we are dancing on a high heel, which is not easy. But you will be not the first and not the last to be in balance if you are searching for this. The life for the women, we can say, is more difficult. Okay, but not impossible. That's why you have to work for it. You have to try to be as much as possible in connection with on the floor to be able to be connected with yourself, and then automatically you will be connected with your partner. This is what we lost. We are losing often the focus to what we have to do to achieve our best dancing, and of course, also our best result. So there is not something that I tell you, this is totally wrong. No, you must understand this. The hips, if you don't bend the hips, this is for me, Simona, totally wrong, because you don't use anymore the body weight, but all the rest, you have to find with your teacher the best way how you can use your body in the maximum amount, in the maximum way. This is for me what we have to really focus, because for Simona, what we lost is totally this, the identity, the harmony, the details. We are not following the details. We are taking lessons and lessons and lessons to have a big confusion in our head that then we don't know what we are doing during our practice. And when you are in this big mess from outside, we can see that you are, I use often this expression, you are not meat and not fish. You are a soup. Soup, I don't like. Many people doesn't like. So you have to be careful if you want to be white or black. Gray, no good. So that's why you have to know what you are doing. You have to know what is the best for you. You have to know exactly what you want to do. But don't forget that to be able to cover the ballroom dancing floor, you must have fully control of yourself. And that's why the technique and the details will help you as much as possible. Then, when you have your strong part of the technique and the details, you can try many ways, never forgetting the details, of course, never forget the basic technique, but you can find your own way. Stop to watch YouTube, stop to copy the others. You can watch the beautiful couple, because of course, me too, I was in one way watching in my period the couples in front of me, and I had very good couples in front of me. So I had only the inspiration from them, but then I needed the information to understand how these beautiful ladies was doing this beautiful action. Because only in this way, the ballroom dancing for Simona Fancello, only this way the ballroom dancing will have a gain and will have the big improvement for the present and for the future. Until we are too much athletic or only artificial, but we are not real, we don't have a long life. We can have maybe some competition good, but then if you really want to. When I was a children, I had a teacher that was not giving me information to be so much sparkling. And I was arriving always one of the last in that competition, in many competitions. And I was saying to my mother, but you see this couple is dancing, this figure, they are turning, and I don't have these routine. So maybe they are more visual because they dance, I am too much in basic way. The couples that they were dancing this routine, they finished much, much earlier than me. I had more longer and difficult beginning to have much more beautiful, long career. So I hope this message arrived to you clear, and I'm sure each of you can take like a treasure these informations. I didn't have time, we don't have time in 1 hour to speak about many things, but I'm sure what I told you, you will analyze in yourself, and you will have tomorrow, one day, or maybe already this evening, one day practice that you will find with your teacher the way how you want to dance the style that you want to present on the floor. So I'm thanking very, very, very much again the WTC, and you should thank also the WTC that gave to you this opportunity, not only with Simona, but with many great teachers already from August, I think August, September, until December, you will have each week a great teacher with a great information. And then with this great information, you will go to your teacher and you will discuss and you will see which information will be good for you in this moment to improve, to achieve your result. So thank you once again to the WDC. We are very lucky to be in this wonderful organization, and I say to you goodbye, and we're really looking forward to meet each other soon, as soon as possible, in the real world on the dancing floor.